Race my hometown Grand Prix, if you like, with Damon starting 26th, sorry, and Coulter 25th. I will give him a bit more of agility compared to Damon for the start to be consistent and quick on passing cars. And we will face the worst scenario for us with two Ferraris and two Benettons in the top four. So our target is to arrive at least 4th and 5th with both cars, and the rest of the field will put us behind the two Simtex. So let's hope to have a start properly managed. I know very much myself, I know how I can be very tricky at the beginning of the race, of each race. Prepare yourself for the first chicanes, because the 1994 layout is not the current one. So you will see the Goodyear 1 and Goodyear 2 double chicanes. I told you. Okay, now the only thing left, let's see what happened, but I think it was Alboreto or Martini with the Minardi. Martini. Okay. So the only thing you can do is go to the pit, change the front wing, and load all the fuel to finish the race. It's the only option I think we have to be maybe not quick as the potential of the car gives, but at least we can. Okay, sorry for morbidelli maybe, but at least I think we can save one pit stop more, and we'll be in the balance of the car of the race. Sorry, 30 seconds saved. Also, because when you drive on circuits where the average speed is very high, in this case we are over 200 kilometers per hour per lap as an average, you lose a lot of time in the pit stop. While the others are running very fast, you lose a lot, differently from Monte Carlo for example. So I don't want to stop anymore this car. At least I have to stop it in the right spot. I will restart last, maybe two laps of buffer, not more. Long pit stop, and now we have just to score a constant pace and not think about the rest. I'm sorry for morbidelli for the previous crash, my mistake. I think we will be around 127, given the fuel load. Worst, 128. Let's see if we can. At least improve. Okay, 127 is decent, but not enough. Yes, 127 seems to be our pace. At least we are racing more or less with Verstappen and Hakkinen and Barrichello, if I take back the result of qualification. The problem is now understand the computer how we drive this heavy loaded car. I don't know really what to expect. Anyway, Schumacher first. Hill is down in 12th position with 27 as best lap. And the computer that is giving us troubles, giving the car back in the middle of the first chicane. I was saying, because the top lap time of this car with half of the fuel load of the current used by David, I think the computer is slower than me, because if David was running at 27 driven by me with fuel completely loaded in the car, I expect a 126 or a 125.9 from this car with half of the fuel loaded. Okay, this is good. Good, 125.4. This could be a lap time. No, I don't say so. Ninth, this was Irvine. Wow, this is a decent lap time. Thanks to the slipstream for sure. But what a lap time! Let's go for the sixth. Okay, sixth. And now we have Brundle or Häkkinen in front of us, and we score a 125. Good. This should be Gianni Morbidelli. That's what David I've clashed with at the beginning of the race. And here we are with Häkkinen. Then we should have in front just Verstappen, Alesi, Berger and Schumacher. David, 18th, with the best lap time of 27, but the last one 28, because it was the computer driving. So we have to go back in charge. At least we are not one lap down so far, from what I see. We are just in the between the two Minardis. I don't have anything to lose with David, and I'm very sorry because after the win in Belgium I was back in the fight for the brothers' title. We can only hope. Score at least one or two points. No, we will not. Sorry, David, nothing personal, but this is not the way I was looking to place you in the Drivers Championship scenario, with at this point for you 4 races left and just 40 points scoreable. But stop it. What happened to Schumacher? I've increased the reliability of his car, of the Benetton team. There goes first. Again, engine problem. I don't know. There's something wrong with GRANDprix 2 reliability, because I've increased since the start of the season. I've increased the Benetton reliability starting from the original, let's say, setup of the game. And again, Schumacher retired. I'm sorry. I don't know what to do more than this. I can maybe just reduce to zero the reliability index of Benetton. Is understand if Damon can win the race. Ferrari arriving second and third would be just sort of good management of both rankings. Not bad, a 126. Great, David. This is a pace. Now I see in front of me the other Benetton, so Damon passed Verstappen and he's looking for the two Ferraris if they are not too far. Could be at least a podium, well deserved for the British driver. Do not want to comment. Sorry. The crash of David is really not the right day. Stop and then run very fast as much as possible. Also with the second part of the race. New fastest lap of the race, Damon. Both. Okay, maybe Gerard is not so far as I was thinking, because if we are close 10 seconds to Jean, it could have been with 4 or 5 seconds of advantage over Jean. Okay. There's Johnny Herbert, the retardant. That is in the pit. We still have 2 laps to do. Not a beautiful lap this one. A new lap record, wow. Okay, it's time to go back to David. Having 21 seconds of advantage over Berger is not enough to exit from the pit stop in front, but at least we will be maybe between Berger and Alesi. Okay, sorry, but I show you one thing. This is the bad part of GRANDprix 2 that doesn't consider a turn. So it placed the almost the neutral to then give you the car in the middle of a chicane. It's really silly. So we do another pit stop for David, hoping to not clash with Damon in front of me. Could have been more cautious, but I was not anyway in the condition to recognize how they could brake so hard. I've made a mistake, I did another, and now this one, it's like I could almost retire the car and concentrate on Damon to try to win the race, but we are almost 2 laps down. I don't want to give up for David. Damon now in the pit, so we are not overlapped anymore. I just don't understand who is in front of me now. Also because David had anyway a decent pace, 125 is not a bad thing having the car so hammered by fuel, and with almost the entire first part of the race done. Not bad. Another improvement. I don't know what I was doing. Let's have a replay. There was Barrichello with a suspension failure that decelerated immediately, and Hakkinen has lost a wheel. The oh wow. Wow. So after the end of this lap we could be 11th. So we are anyway one lap down. Maybe we can score, I don't know, 1 point, I don't know. There will be others. There will be other retirements for sure. Wow, what a race. So we have Damon has to recover 7 seconds. 7 seconds away. I see a red car in front of me. 1 second recovered despite 2 overlapped cars to pass. Another record. So far, easy peasy, best Berger. Let's try to not give him slipstream. Thank you. I knew it. It was all too easy. But we will now race like hell. Because if the podium is more or less possible, I do not accept in 15 laps to not try to charge back the Ferraris. And I must gain 2 seconds per lap, minimum. At least we have to catch Jean-Louise. I hope the computer will drive fast as I do. And David is 5 seconds far. Was 5 seconds far from Blondel. Again, we had this nice change of driving command from artificial to human inside the chicane. And this is the last opportunity to hope for a 6th place at least. No, no, it will be not. It's clear that today David has will not exit from parabolic gravel. No, we are stuck here. Sorry for David, but from the parabolic gravel you can not very often can exit, so we concentrate on Damon's race. Sorry David, you have a big credit with luckiness. And now let's see if we can at least arrange a better result for Damon. The same setup for cars. I found really strangely drivable David's car today. Here we have a smoking turkey, a Jordan. So David was in the point. No way. Berger retired for what? Transmission. Wow, he was the leader of the race. This is Alesi passing. And this is Damon arriving. So at this point we have the opportunity to win the race easily. Or at least in an easier way compared to the fact see a red car in front of me. Is the Ferrari left on track with Jean Alesi. Ahead of him I see two overlapped cars. And he's losing a lot of time. So maybe we can sneak inside now. Maybe the next chicane will be the place for the pass. Yes, it is. Let's go to see this. Almost historic pass. The French driver maybe was not completely ready to defend his position. I'm curious about the break point for him. We break at 100 meters from the chicane, usually. Maybe 10 12 meters after them. And now we have 7 laps to race in first position, hoping to not make mistakes. Is it destroyed by the pass? Or maybe the gap between drivers to understand what David could have done? I can't believe it. What are you doing? What are you doing in front? Jean-Marc Gounon, but can you stop in the center of the track? It's something really... The AI of this game sometimes is silly. Okay, we have half of the... What I mean is, if you break it, break. Choosing a side or another, you don't stay in the middle. Because we had almost 2 seconds of gap of pace better than Alesi, I hope at least to drive on 126. Already 7 tenths regained by Jean. No. Okay, in the worst scenario now the second place is got. Is taken. We have just to resist 4 laps. It will become 1 second. Two laps to go. last lap. Yes. Sorry. Let me save the game because it will never happen again in my life to have a final like this. I thought, okay, I've lost the race. That's it. But I was also thinking we are quicker. I think that we would have won anyway because we were quicker. From a pure speed point of view, then the artificial intelligence did break to get the slipstream, but if you can see, he was already second for the position indicator. Second now, yes, I would have won anyway. But what a grand finale, as just to take an Italian word. What a final. Without the front wing, it's not really something that you can see in real life. But GRANDprix 2 is nice also for this reason. I just don't know why the computer breaks to get this slipstream. It's a bug for sure. Anyway, almost a photo finish. It would have been under the 10th, I think. Let's see if I can. Yes, this could have been the final distance. I was gaining more or less half of the car. Wow. Let me save again, I can't believe this. Okay. So, now that the race is over, finally, I'm more than happy to have won in my home race, almost. Let's see who was then third, maybe Verstappen. Yes, it still has to arrive. We had, I think, 40 seconds of the gap with Alesi. Anyway, another podium for the Dutch driver. Let's see how far from Jean. We don't see it. We will see at the end of the race. Blundell fifth. Seventh Alboreto. De Cesaris sixth in Italy. Fourth Katayama, but one lap down. I think with Coulthard we could have been here. Or fifth or fourth, I'm sorry, really. Happy for the win, but sorry for the race of the Scott driver. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you very much for watching with me and racing with me. I hope you have enjoyed the race as I did. Really one of the, maybe my best last lap of 25 years playing Grand Prix 2. And anyway, I give you the appointment for the debrief in the next video. So far, thank you very much again. As always, stay home, stay safe, stay racing. Ciao.